Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's see the basics of a reaction called the Diels-Alder reaction. Across the top of the screen is the Diels-Alder reaction. The Diels-Alder cycloaddition was first reported in 1928, and it was immediately embraced as a great way to make rings. The essential details are on the slide. The reaction requires two starting materials. One must be a diene, specifically a conjugated diene. A conjugated diene has two pi bonds, made those darker, separated by a single sigma bond, and I've drawn an arrow to that. The other starter material must contain a pi bond that will react with the diene. What do you call a pi bond that loves to react with a diene? A dienophile. I'm being serious. It's called a dienophile. The six atoms of the diene and dienophile react together in such a manner that they form a six-membered ring transition state. It's shown in the middle of the slide. In one step, all the bond breaking and all the bond forming occur at the same time to give a new cyclic product. Now we're over on the far right. There are no carbocations and no carbanions. The product has a six-membered ring and will always contain at least one pi bond. The most common product does contain just one pi bond and will be a cyclohexene, although additional pi bonds and rings are possible. Let's add some more details. First, the diene. Remember that the diene must be conjugated. This is a conjugated diene, two pi bonds separated by a single bond. This is also a conjugated diene. This is a diene, but it's not a conjugated diene. The two pi bonds, 1, 2, are separated by two single bonds, not just one. This last diene would not be able to undergo a Diels-Alder reaction. It's a diene, but it's not a conjugated diene. Second, and still with the diene, let's talk about the conformation of the diene. Our original diene has two preferred conformations. This is the original one that we've shown. This is called the s-cis conformation, and an additional one. This is called s-trans. These conformations interconvert by rotation about the single bond in the middle. The s-trans conformation is more stable, but the s-cis is the one that does the Diels-Alder conformation. Therefore, in order to do a Diels-Alder, the diene must be able to access the less stable s-cis conformation. Here is an example of a conjugated diene that cannot do a Diels-Alder reaction because a conjugated diene cannot access the s-cis conformation. The middle bond cannot rotate because it's locked in a ring. It's locked as s-trans. No s-cis, no Diels-Alder. A third detail, let's talk about R groups. You can have R groups on your diene coming off the different carbons. In general, the diene has electron donating groups as the R groups. So most dienes are electron rich. The dienophile normally has electron withdrawing groups. So most dienophiles are electron poor. The electronic difference between the diene and dienophile help them react more quickly. Those are the essential ideas of the Diels-Alder reaction. The cycloaddition is a one-step reaction of a conjugated diene with a dienophile to form a cyclohexene cycloaddict.